I'm Herbie Gaylord, and this is Bright, stories of hope and innovation in Michigan classrooms, a podcast where we celebrate our state's educators and explore the future of learning. In this mini-series called Lessons Learned, we're pausing to reflect on some of our favorite takeaways from season one of Bright. In today's episode, we explore a theme that surfaced often during our conversations thus far, the primacy of relationships in teaching and learning. Over and over again, our guests, whether they taught in online or face-to-face classrooms, came back to this central tenet. At the end of the day, the best way to teach someone is to get to know them and develop a personal connection. First up, we've got Ben Gilpin, principal of Warner Elementary School, who shares his journey into education and why, as principal, each year he memorizes all of the names of his 400-plus elementary students.
I did not love school when I was growing up. I'm probably pretty average in saying that there were some classes that I really connected with the teacher, and there were some that I absolutely despised it and stared out that window and could not wait for the bell to ring and for myself to be able to get out of there. But I think that's probably the experience that a lot of us had. I would not have anticipated that I was going to be in education. I was going to be a professional golfer, right? No, that didn't happen. But I was not going to be an educator. My wife, when she was my girlfriend, she said, you know, you're really good with people. You're really good with kids. And that kind of got me to start thinking about that. So I changed my major three times. So for this is a bit of a side note, but it is on the same topic. You're not going to hear me say to kids, what are you going to be when you grow up? I want to talk to them about their dreams, but I didn't know what I wanted to be. So I had dreams, but I didn't know what I wanted to be. So that's just not something I typically do. Once I got into education, I was this confident, not arrogant, kid that believed I could change the world. And I thought, you know what? There was so much in education I didn't like. I can change that. I can be the change that the education needs. And so I went into it very driven and very motivated to do that. And I knew that it started with the relationship. It always starts with the relationship. And so from day one, as a teacher, it was about getting to know my kids. It was about going on home visits first year. It was about visiting the community. It was about doing things that were engaging and fun. You know, rarely did we sit there at the desk and get out the book and read and take notes. That just was not my style. A lot of the ways I taught, I love to take the online games, Jeopardy, Wheel of Fortune, you name it. I love to take those games and make them into lessons. Being a fifth grade teacher, when they came out with the with that TV game show, Smarter Than a Fifth Grader, oh man, I made that a staple in my classroom. So it was all about making it fun. When I transitioned to principal, it was the same way. I wanted to make it engaging and fun. I wanted to get to know kids. I wanted to be visible. I wanted to connect with kids. And I knew the best way to connect with kids is, as soon as I see them, to know their name. And so I stand at the front door every single morning, and even when they have a mask on, I can still name them all. So it's always mattered, because to me, relationships have to come first.
You can hear more from Ben Gilpin in episode 9 of Bright, titled When School Feels Like Home, Something Wonderful Happens. Next up, we have Ben Ashby, or Senor Ashby, as he's known in his Spanish classroom at Zeeland Public Schools and to his online students at Michigan Virtual. Ben shares what 13 years of serving both as a face-to-face and online teacher has taught him about building relationships with students.
I would say the first thing, no matter whether you're teaching online or face-to-face, is just building relationships with kids. And it looks different when you're teaching 100% online. But, you know, the similarities there are, you know, I still try to use the same goofy rap songs or make the same goofy jokes that I would in my online classes I do in my face-to-face class. And, you know, kids have the same struggles face-to-face as they do online, and just kind of how you build those relationships and what those relationships look like online is a little bit different, but there's still, it's still an important piece.
This is something I've heard from every single online teacher I've spoke to, is that relationships are the center of the online classroom. That's kind of, you know, there's a kind of some misconceptions about that. You might think because it's online, like, oh, you don't talk to your teacher. But so many said, I actually form really, you know, great relationships with my students online because I have this one-on-one time to meet with them in the asynchronous model. But you mentioned that it looks different, the way that you do it online versus in your face-to-face classroom. And I'm wondering if you could speak to that and keep kind of a practical mind to it of like, you know, what advice would you give a face-to-face teacher who's trying to build that in an online environment?
I would say take your strengths of connecting with kids and make them work in the online environment. So like, for example, on the first day of class face-to-face, I always talk about myself and my family because I think it's important for kids to connect with you as a person first. And so, you know, in the online setting, I have this PowerPoint where I do two truths and a lie with my kids face to face. So I've made that same video and I make it new every year for my online kids. And so, you know, it looks different. It's not me delivering it in front of a classroom. It's me making a video. I show pictures of my family day one in class, so I do that with my online students as well. I even, you know, I always try to just make things fun, and, you know, I like to think that I'm pretty funny whether my students do or not. So I try to make the same stupid jokes I would make in the video. I've got, like, this weird picture of myself holding my two-year-old son at the time, and then I Photoshopped the heads and made my son's head mine and my head his, so to speak. And so, I don't know, I have a bunch of jokes that I tell about that picture to my students. So, you know, it's using your strengths. You know, it's not, you don't have to reinvent the wheel. You just have to kind of reinvent yourself a little bit and do the same things you normally do, but just a little bit different.
You can hear more from Ben in episode 12 of Bright, titled "The Delightful Power of Music to Make Learning More Engaging." Next up, we have Christy Trombetta, an online math teacher at Michigan Virtual, who shares the shift in perspective she experienced as she grew into her teaching values and how this shift in mindset has changed the way she interacts with her students.
I think my whole philosophy on teaching changed too, though, from like the beginning when I started out as a teacher. I think when I started out as a teacher, I really felt like I'm teaching math and that's what I'm going to do. I'm really good at math and I can teach these students math and it's going to be great. And my philosophy now is that, yes, I'm teaching math. I love math. It's great. But really, I'm teaching students. And if I want them to learn the math, I have to get to know my students. And they have to get to know me a little bit too, because they're not going to be comfortable sharing information with me if they don't know me a little bit. So my approach now is much different. I get to know the students first, and then we work on the math.
You can hear more from Christy in episode 8 of Bright, titled "Why Growth Mindsets Are So Important for Student Success in Math." Thank you for joining us for this episode of Bright, where we synthesize some of our lessons learned from season one on how relationships are truly the heart and soul of teaching. This is our last lessons learned episode for season one. In the next couple of weeks, we'll be back with season two of Bright, which will feature shorter episodes as we dive straight to the heart of the issues and innovations at hand. The Bright podcast is produced by me, Herbie Gaylor, is hosted by Nikki Herda, and is made possible by Michigan Virtual, a nonprofit organization that's leading and collaborating to build learning environments for tomorrow. Education is changing faster than ever. Discover new models and resources to move learning forward at your school at michiganvirtual.org.